people are loving this show.
Yeah, it's exciting to get instant fans.
Instant,
like,
yeah.
Jumping on board, and we've got great numbers, so we're hoping.
Good thing.
So
yeah.
Everybody needs to come back. And
yeah, come back
tonight.
Again.
Again. 9 o'clock.
This is based on the comic book, too, right?
It is, yeah. It's based on the comic book loosely, like, sort of like that was, like, our jumping off point.
Yeah.
And then from there, we get into, like, you know, because the comic book's one-dimensional. So
right.
You know, make the characters a little bit more three-dimensional and complex and flawed.
Speaking of complex and flawed, your character plays Lucifer's therapist, and you have kind of an unconventional relationship.
Unconventional. What do you mean unconventional?
For
yeah.
That's right.
No, well, Lucifer finds out that she is, she can see things in him that's different than anybody else, like that he calls her sort of like a complex person. So he decides that he will actually start talking to her as a therapist because he's decided to leave hell and come to Los Angeles because that makes sense.
Yeah.
Right.
Right.
Exactly. So he's there and has some issues to work out. He's got some daddy issues with his father.
Yeah.
I don't know that he is the devil, so I'm treating him as a delusional patient. And what ends up happening is that you have to see the show, but I end up, he pays me back with intimacy.
Of the face.
Yeah, yes. Favor. It's daytime.
And only Lucifer would do.
It's daytime, right? So we, yeah, so we make out and stuff.
Yeah, well, that's payback.
That's payment, yeah. Yes. So
that's payback.
That's definitely not unconventional.
It's right.
Yeah, right.
Well, okay, but fans are really crazy about this show, and two episodes only, and people are already making dolls.
I know, they're already making plushie dolls.
Of you.
On my Twitter page, my profile picture is my plushie doll.
Are you okay with that?
Yeah, how does this feel? There she is.
Yeah, so cute.
And they have glasses.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the cutest thing. So what do you think people are latching on to? I think it's because Lucifer is the most, like, irredeemable, am I saying that word? Irredeemable person ever. And he is seeking redemption. So it's like, if all of us have something that we regret that you're hoping people can forgive us for, or
right,
that makes us more likable, and it's, all in all, the show is about humanity and redemption, which sounds crazy because it's about the devil, but that's really, it's about humanity.
Yeah, that makes sense. Speaking of forgiveness, let's talk about Suits. Because your character on Suits, I don't know if fans are going to be able to forgive her. Big moment.
I know. That was a big moment. Yeah. I didn't realize it either. I was just stunned. I mean, I wasn't stunned.
Yeah.
Watching it with the fans, but when I read the script, I didn't expect to be the one that outed him. But I do love that the reason why, because the creator, Aaron Porsche, had said he wanted it to be not because somebody was trying to get back at Mike, but
right,
because it was actually just the right thing to do.
Yeah, so we should specify that you sold Mike out.
Oh, spoiler alert.
The show is set up on a young man who is pretending to be an attorney.
Yes.
And he is not. He's pretending to have gone to Harvard. You know, are a recruiter for Harvard and law firms and things
right
like that, and you reveal to the U.S. attorney that he is not an attorney, which is a huge
big thing. I'm forgetting, like, we're not in front of, like, every suit fan.
Let me just say, give me the quick and the dirty.
I know. It's great, and you'll see more of Sheila Sass.
Yeah, okay.
Good. Be careful that you say that.
Yes, I was
saying. Well, I'm glad you said it, and I didn't. All right, well, you can catch Rachel and Lucifer every Monday at 9 p.m. on Fox. Thanks so much for stopping by.
I
love to be the video guys. Yeah,
all right, we'll be right back. How many pairs of glasses?
The perfect gift. One